Hello puzzle lovers, my name is Michael and welcome back for a new episode of the Luban Log Puzzle Series. Intro now. Hey, what's up? Today we are going to attempt to solve another Luban Log puzzle. Yes, and this one is different from the previous one. You will see why in a few seconds. It looks very nice and very interesting and quite challenging. So let's just jump into it so you can check it out. So this is the Luban Log puzzle that we are going to attempt to solve today. Look at it. It looks very nice and quite neat actually. So you can see that there is different color of cubes. So it's small cubes making a bigger one. And that's very nice. So now, why is this one different from the previous one? First, because the disassemble step is different. You don't have to remove anything from it. Everything is just one piece. You can see I already start to move it and every small cubes are connected to each other. That's very nice and interesting. This puzzle is called the snake cube and you will see why once we disassemble it. Really, I'm sure it will be challenging because if I'm going too fast when I disassemble it, it will be a nightmare to put it back in a cube shape. Now, how this wooden puzzle is made? Very simple, you have a lot of small cubes and they are all connected by a string inside. I'm not sure if you can see it, but inside there is the string that connects every pieces all together. So the aim is simple, always disassemble it and put it back at its original shape. So we will try that, we will see how it goes, but I hope it will be not too much a nightmare to try to solve. So now each pieces of this cube will have a proper position to make this happen. So let's just start to solve it. So you can see that you can really move everything like you want. Well, almost like you want. Like this cube, for example, you can just rotate it like this and you cannot really like rotate it like this. Otherwise you will kind of break the string. And also that give a specific purpose to this cube. So we will try to disassemble it. Okay, so this U shape will kind of close everything together and maybe it's everything is like a U shape. Oh, interesting actually, yeah. At the end, everything is like a U shape. So we keep going. Oh, that's where the U shape is stopping. So right here, we stop here. And then this one goes here. Okay. Then, oh, it goes here. Okay, that's interesting because then we have this shape here that is different. Okay, that makes it very interesting for so far. So we keep going on. So we that will be really messy. So now you will see why we call it the snake cube. Okay, so I guess like this, and then you just end up like this. And I do think you have to turn this one and then you turn it like this. So I guess that's the final shape of it. Yeah, I think that's it. So that's what it looks like disassembled. It looks very neat, very nice. You can see like it has this kind of snake shape, but that will be a nightmare to put it back together. Because at the end, you can see that we spotted some U shape. But at the beginning, not at all. It's a bit random. So we might have gone too fast to see what happened at the end, but that's nice because then it will keep the challenge to try to solve back this puzzle. So now step two, put it back together to its original shape as a cube. So we will start with this piece, I guess. So I remember it was like this. Then there was something here, like kind of not like this. This part had something different. maybe like this, and then like this. I think it was something like this, yeah. Okay, we will just try that, or we can also try to make this U shape here. That could be another solution. Like we have this U shape at the end, and then we are most like a kind of U shape on the second stage, but it kind of stopped here in the middle because then we went through the middle of one of the face of the cube with this part here. So we had this U shape at the end, and then it follow another side, and then from the other side you will go. I feel we went kind of in the middle. Oh yeah, it was like this, then we were starting to go in the middle. Okay, maybe on the other side would be easier because I remember this U shape. Okay, then we kind of did like this. It was kind of a U shape, but then we get inside. So we had this cube missing from the second U shape. So we get inside, and then from inside, that is where I'm not sure. What can we do? We can do that, maybe. And then we could do that, but then we, okay. We can get this one inside and then continue. Okay, so we can get, I said we can get this one inside. So like we add this inside, and so we need to continue to put this inside. So this will go inside, and that was the end. Because if I can manage to put this whole thing inside, I just need to rotate all the thing together. If I rotate this, then I can finish my puzzle. Okay, so let's just try to be careful of what we are doing. So wait, we said this need to be inside, and then we go around it. Okay, that's easier to start with the end, but then no. Okay, again, that's a bit annoying, because I think I got it, but because I cannot put everything back inside, then I was stuck. So here, then we say up there, and it's here, but everything needs to fit because this will go inside, this will go inside, we said. No. Okay, I messed somewhere. So here, like this, here, and then that goes in. That bit goes in, and I should be able to put everything inside. How do I do that? Well, I mean, I could just lose up. I could just like play with a string to put back everything, but maybe that would be a bit cheating. So wait, I need to put this one inside. So if I put, okay, let's do it like this. So I need to put this one inside, and then this has to get inside from here, so it will arrive here. So if we have this here, then we need to turn this like this, so we go here, And then from here we need to go down. No, not really. I need to, these two come here and I'm here, then I need to turn here and then I need to go down and then like this. Okay, so that's my end, my missing end on the other side.
A few moments later.
So I know this needs to come like, I think it needs to come like this. No. This needs to come like this. That's my end. And then we need something on top. Coming on top, we need something which is this one, I think. So I have my top part, and then from here, I mean, there's not so many options, just except to just do that. So we have this, and then from here, again, you don't have much choice than just to rotate this one. And you arrive here. Here again, you have this row of three cubes, so the only way to fit it is like this. It's like this, that's okay. So far, and then now the only option for me is to go down, because then I can just rotate this one to do something with it and to put it in the middle like this. But then once I done that, I'm kind of screwed because I have these three that just don't fit. So it's where I don't know what I did wrong. This thing inside is wrong. Maybe. No, it's not. So what? Is it just... So I need to do that and then from here, turn here. And then what? I mean, I need to put this somewhere. There is something wrong going on here and I don't know what. Unless I go on top like this. Okay, I did find something interesting. Oh, is it the end? Oh, it's the end. Whoa, okay. So I think I did miss something. Here, where was it? Not here, but here. Yeah, I was missing something here. I didn't saw that this one could turn, I think. And so I was kind of stuck doing something like this. But if I go up and then I can turn this one as well. This white one can turn and then can fit here. Then you fit and you have something not working again. Okay, wait. Give me a second. Why now? But I think I did find the solution. Why did I just mess that? Okay, so I can go up, but that's not it. So it's like this. No. What did I... damn it. Because I know it's this one that need to go up. This one need to go up. This one needs to go up. And then you can turn this one and then up your three piece and then just keep going and finishing. So it's this one that was my main problem since the beginning, because I don't know why I thought maybe I couldn't turn it, but yeah, solved. Finally, this one is solved. The snake cube is solved. Finally, another Luban lock puzzle solved. Yeah, victory for me. This one was something. It was very challenging, and to be honest, it messed with my brain. It is a very cool and nice wooden puzzle. If you want to give it a try, just go for it. It's really nice and you have a very good satisfaction when you finish it. Promise about it. Now, I hope you did enjoy this video, that you love this series, that you enjoy seeing all these wooden puzzles that I'm solving. If you do, please subscribe to the channel, really, it will mean so much for me. And if you enjoy this video, like it and go watch the other puzzles from this series. They are very nice as well. More of them are coming. And now, I see you next week for a new puzzle. Tschüss!